the numbers were expected to spike again.
Kids will be back in the classroom.
Rapid tests will become part of the morning routine.
As communities prepare for a spike in cases.
Instead, COVID numbers across the nation are still trending down. And while cases in schools are increasing, classrooms remain open.
School's back and the results are just terrific.
In Victoria and New South Wales, staff and students are provided with twice-weekly free rats.
Well, it's not the easiest to test a five-year-old.
It's really invasive.
Yeah, it's a nightmare.
Like, it's up there.
We have a box of ice blocks at home for the bribery.
And according to a small daily telly poll, some parents in New South Wales don't see the point. One in three polled not complying.
We are testing him probably twice every 10 days. We're doing it maybe not exactly twice a week.
And some experts question the policy.
If you test asymptomatic children, you'll miss half the cases. And the reality is children aren't a big factor in spread. So probably you don't get a lot of benefit from it relative to the cost and the inconvenience of doing it.
In South Australia, students test to stay if there's a positive classroom case, cleared for school if they return a negative rat. And in Queensland, only symptomatic children are required to take a test.
Schools are still managing very well. There's been no school closures, which is great news.
Opening doors, opening windows, all of that will have a much bigger effect than doing rat testing on asymptomatic children.
But modelling by the Burnet Institute shows that in Victoria,
with an assumption of 75% compliance, we've actually prevented more than 21,000 COVID-19 cases in our students.
The state announcing it will continue to provide testing right through until the end of term one.
That will prevent 150,000 cases in the community and around 400 hospital admissions.
New South Wales still considering whether to follow suit.
We're currently working on our school's plan. I know it has been a challenge.
A challenge these parents are up to.
It's working quite well, actually.
If you're catching some cases, then it can't be a bad thing.
I think a lot of children are just happy to go to school.
So as Australia continues to ride this Omicron wave, are weekly rapid tests the best way to ensure the kids are okay?
My eldest, Frida, she just started school. It was now week three or something of prep. And when she started, there was a nice letter that was sent out to all the parents of one of the kids that's at that school. Off memory, he's in grade five or six or something like that, but he had a heart transplant when he was two. So he's taken immunisation suppression drugs to make sure that his body won't reject the heart. But of course, then he's susceptible to anything going around, especially COVID. And so they gave it to us with the rapid tests. And I was like, look, I don't want to do it. No one wants to do it, especially to their kids. But I'm like, it's a good lesson, I think, for her to learn that she has to look after herself so that she can look after the greater community and the people who need it. Because it is only 30 seconds. It's 15 seconds up each nostril. Like, I did one this afternoon. It's not pleasant, but it passes. And at least she understands she's doing that to look after someone because they're going to be in a lot worse condition if she does have
it. Do you think she has got her head around that?
I don't know. Certainly after the test, no. You know, there's 10, 15 minutes of crying and dad's doing everything to placate her. There's lollies galore on TV.
I think the question is, does your daughter have empathy? I think
that's what I was getting at. There's a lot bigger things afoot. Is that what you're telling
me? Exactly how bad a father are you, Dothorta?
Oh, jeez, a lot has happened in this break. I'm not going to lie.
Just do your Husey and move on.
Do the rapid empathy test and get back to us.
Are you so glad you shared now?
Yeah, it's good to open up here at the project.
It's interesting, though. Like, the rats weren't going to catch every case. It wasn't about that, was it?
But, no.
So, you know, my kids have no problem doing it.
No, but I can see the argument for waiting, only doing it with symptomatic testing, because there's that question about, and like there's a lot of arguments about this, but questions about when you test asymptomatic, do you actually catch cases anyway? And so given the cost, could those rats be deployed somewhere else? Like, I can see there's an argument to be had there, whatever they ultimately decide.
Yeah.